Good morning, children. Welcome to the science class once again. I hope you have watched the video and solved the worksheet that I had uploaded on last Thursday. Today, in this video, we are going to learn something new that is beyond our textbook. Alright? So now, do you remember this picture, children? Yes, I have put this picture in your worksheet. So, can you tell me what is basically happening here? Yes, the flowers of the apple tree are getting pollinated. Next is the fertilization is happening there. Then what happens after fertilization? The whole ovary turns into the fruit and the ovules turn into seeds. Now, if these seeds get favorable conditions, they will turn into new plants. Correct? So in this lesson, we learned about how new plants are developed from the seeds. Now children, I'm going to show you some images where some new plants are growing. Now can you find any difference in the reproduction process here? There are four images shown here. One is the potato, this is onion, this is ginger, this is carrot. And you can see some new plants are developing from these structures. But are these all seeds? No, these are not seeds. Still, some new plants are coming out. Correct? Isn't it interesting then? Yes. So, these three, as I said, this potato, like your onion, this ginger, all are modified stems. Whereas, this carrot is a modified root. Do you all know about all this? And what do they do? Yes, they do store some food. Okay? Now, you must have noticed, like, if there is any leftover food at your home, what does your mama do? Your mama stores it in the fridge so that it can be used later. Similarly, as we all know that leaves are the kitchen of plants. Correct? They make their own food. And the extra food they store in the stem or in the roots. Okay? And from there, new plants develop. So now, the reproduction process in which new plants develop from the vegetative parts like stem, root and leaves are called as the vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction. Let's know something more about this. Okay? So, vegetative propagation can be done through roots, through stem or through leaf. Okay? Let's start with root. This is a sweet potato and this is a carrot. As I told you, these two are the modified roots. They store food. Still, from them, you can see some new plants are growing from them. Okay? Now, without using seeds. Alright? Next is by stem. As we had already seen, the potato is a modified stem. You can see some eye-like structure here. Like, these are called as the eyes or the notches. From there, birds develop. And from the birds, you can see some new plant. Okay, like if you keep the potato for like 15 to 20 days at your home, you can see some buds coming out from your potato. Now, if you put that in the soil, like along with a little part of potato, you may see a new plant of potato grows out from that. Okay, so next is ginger. It is called as a rhizome. R-H-I-Z-O-M-E. Rhizome. This is also a modified stem. Now you can see a new plant is growing from the ginger. Right? So some few more examples of this. You can see turmeric, bamboo. Okay? And that too without using the seed. Next is a picture of onion. This is also one modified stem. So basically it is called as the bulb. Okay, now this again develops the stem. The stem you can see develops into a new plant, and of course without using the seeds. Okay, here is an example of grass. You can see this aerial stem. Okay, and wherever it gets the favorable condition, new roots will develop and new plants can develop from there. Okay, so example can be strawberry, grass, mint, etc. Now vegetative propagation is done by leaf. This is an example of bryophyllum. You can see some notches over here. You can see some notches. From every notch, new bud-like structures come out. Okay? So when leaf falls on the ground, leaf buds grow to form independent plants. Okay? Next is, so till now what we saw are the natural ways. So naturally, the new plants are growing from this, like potato, carrot, or a sweet potato, etc. Now we are going to see some artificial methods. The first one here comes is the cutting. Okay, I normally do this at my home. What I do is, I have some rose plants. I cut the stem about 6 to 8 inches, and then I remove the leaves, and then I plant it in the soil. After a few days, if it gets proper amount of water and fertilizers, it develops into a new plant. And you can see some beautiful rose flowers are here. This is very easy. You also can try at home. Of course, with the help of your parent. Okay. Next is a layering. This is also very interesting and easy as well. Jasmine. The example you can see is jasmine. How do we do this? We have to take the lower branch of a plant. You can see this is a lower branch of a plant, okay? And then we'll bend it towards the ground and cover it with moist soil, keeping the tip of the branch above the soil. Now, after a few days, you will notice some roots start appearing from the stem. Now, if you cut this stem from here, the new plant will develop independently. Okay, next is a very interesting one. This is called as the grafting. This is a common method used to develop new varieties. You must have noticed that like two or three different color flowers grown on a single plant, right? Like here you can see two different color flowers are growing on a single plant. How is it possible? Yes, it is possible due to this grafting. Normally what this process is, like suppose this is the main stem of the yellow color rose plant, and then this is a stem or stem of red color rose plant. Okay, now you have to fix it here, then you join it. After a few days you can see a single plant having different color flowers. Isn't it interesting? Okay, so with this we all like we have an understanding of vegetative reproduction, where the reproduction happens through the roots, stems, or the like leaves, and some artificial methods as well. So with this we came to an end of today's video. I'll share one worksheet with you as well as based on this concept. I hope you all will do it. And on Thursday, I will share one worksheet with all the question answers of lesson 1. So we'll complete the first lesson on Thursday, coming Thursday. And we'll start the next lesson after the summer vacation gets over. Fine. So goodbye. Stay healthy, stay happy. Thank you.